Hi students, welcome you all to the session. Today we will continue the topic data handling in Python. In the previous class we discussed about data types in Python programming language. Today we will discuss about operators in detail. Let's start today's class. Operators. We already discussed about this operators. The operators are symbol that perform specific operation when applied on variables. Take a look at the expression 10 plus 25. From this you can identify 10 and 25 are operands, plus is the operator. The above statement is an expression, combination of operator and operands. That is, operator operates on operands. Some operator requires two operand and some requires only one operand to operate. Types of operators. First one, arithmetic. Binary operators are those operators that require two operand to operate upon. The following are some binary operators: plus, addition operation, minus, subtraction, star, multiplication, slash, division, modulus, remainder, double star, exponent, double slash, floor division. Types of operators: arithmetic, that is unary operator. They require only one operand to operate, like unary, plus and minus. Example, a is equal to 5. Print positive a, that is 5. Print negative a, that is negative 5. Unary operators, they require only one operand to operate on this operator, plus and minus, positive and negative. Okay. Example for this binary arithmetic operator. Num1 is equal to 20. Num2 is equal to 7. VIL is equal to num1 mod num2. Print VIL. What will be the output? Num1 20 mod num2. Mod operation, it performs the remainder operation. We will get the remainder from this operation. When we are performing this division operation, we will get the answer as 2. Then, what is the remainder after performing this division operation? That is 6. That remainder we will get when we are performing this modulus operation. VIL is equal to num1 mod num2. Print VIL, that value is 6. Then here, VIL is equal to 2 double star 4. That is exponentiation, 2 raised to 4. Print VIL, that is equal to 16. Okay. Then types of operator: augmented assignment operators. It perform operation with LHS and RHS, and result will be assigned to LHS. Plus equal to, RHS added to LHS and result assigned to LHS. X plus equal to 5. That means X is equal to X plus 5. In the same way, all the other operators will work. Minus equal to x minus equal to 5. That means x is equal to x minus 5. Then slash is equal to x slash equal to 5. That means x is equal to x by 5. Double star equal to x double star equal to 5. That means x is equal to x double star 5. Okay, clear? Augmented assignment operators. Then types of relational operators. These operators are used to compare two values and return the result as true or false depending upon the result of comparison. Relational operators or comparison operators. Less than, greater than, less than or equal to, greater than or is equal to, equal to, not equal to. Less than, check this example, 50 less than 45 returns false. If you are checking this one, then it will return the answer as false. Why? 50 less than false, that condition false. Then 40 less than 60, this condition true. 50 greater than 45, this is true. 40 greater than 60, that condition false. 50 less than or is equal to 50, then it will return true. 80 less than or is equal to 70, that returns false. 40 greater than or is equal to 40, that returns true. 40 greater than or is equal to 90, that returns false. 80 equal to 80, that is true. 60 equal to 80, that is false. 45 not equal to 90, that condition true. 80 not equal to 80, that condition false. These are the relational operators. Few points to remember, comparisons. For numeric types, the values are compared after removing trailing zeros after decimal point from floating point number. Example, 6 and 6.0 will be treated as equal. Then, capital letters, ASCII code 65 to 90. The ASCII code of capital letters are 65 to 90. In between 65 to 90 are considered as less than small letters. Small letters ASCII codes are in between 97 to 122. Check this one, hello less than hello. It will give the result as true because capital H is smaller than small h at the time of comparing the ASCII code. In string, be careful with comparison. In string, be careful while comparison because special characters are also assigned to some ASCII code, like ASCII code of space is 32. Enter is 13. Enter keys ASCII code is 13. Space keys ASCII code is 32. Check this one, hello equal to hello. False, because there is a space before H in second string. This one is the second string. Here you can see one space. So this condition false. Like other programming language, in Python also we have to be very careful while comparing floating value because it may gives you unexpected result. So it is suggested not to use equality testing with floating values. Comparison with the floating values. Check this one. 0.1 plus 0.1 plus 0.1. That is equal to 0.3. It will return false. How and why? Let us check the value of 0.1 plus 0.1 plus 0.1. Check this one. The output is 0.3, then this much zeros, then last 4. That is why this condition is false. In Python, floating numbers are approximately presented in memory in binary form up to the allowed precision 15 digit. These 15 digit it will take for storing a float type value. This approximation may yield unexpected result if you are comparing floating value using equality. Okay. Relational operator with arithmetic operators. You can use this relational operator with arithmetic operators. Relational operator have lower priority than arithmetic operators. So, if any arithmetic operator is involved with the relational operator, then first arithmetic operation will be solved, then compare that expressions. Example, a comma b comma c is equal to 10 comma 20 comma 30. A plus 10, greater than b minus 10. First, it will calculate the expression a plus 10 and b minus 10. After that, it will check the condition. A's value 10. 10 plus 10, that is 20. B's value 20. 20 minus 10, that is 10. 20 greater than 10. That condition true. So the result is true. Here comparison will be 20 greater than 10. Okay, clear? What is the difference between this A is equal to 60 and A equal to 60? If the value of A is 100, what is the difference between the below two statements? Here we are checking A's value is equal to 60. Here this equal to is the comparison operator or relational operator. Here we are checking the condition. A is equal to 60. 100 is equal to 60. It will return the result as false. In the next statement, A is equal to 60. That means we are assigning 60 value to the variable A. Equal to is the assignment operator. Equal to is the assignment operator. Equal to is the comparison operator or relational operator. Sure question? So study this one in a proper way. Okay. The next one, identity operator. These operators are used to check if both objects are pointing to same memory address or not. Identity operator. Is A is B. Return true if both operands are pointing to same memory location. Otherwise, false. Is not. A is not B. Return true if both operands are not pointing to same memory location. Otherwise, false. Example, A is equal to 10, B is equal to 10, C is equal to 20. A is B. Okay, we will get the answer as true. A is C. False. A is not C. True. C minus equal to 10. That means C is equal to C minus 10. C's value 20. 20 minus 10, 10. A is C. That is true. A's value 10. C's value also 10. So we will get the answer as true. Okay. Equality versus identity. Equality, that is equal to. Identity, that is. When we compare two variables pointing to same value, then both equality, equal to and identity is will return true. A comma B is equal to 10 comma 10. A equal to B. True. A is B. That also true. But in few cases, when two variables are pointing to same value, equal to will return true and is will return false. Okay. Example, S1 is equal to one string KVOEF. S2 is equal to input enter any string. Enter any string, we entered the same string stored in this S1 itself. KVOEF. S1 equal to S2. That time we will get the answer as true. But here S1 is S2. We will get the answer as false. S3 is equal to KVOEF. S1 is S3. This time we will get the answer as true. Here few cases are the Python creates two different objects that store the same value. First one, input of string from the console. Second one, dealing with a large integer value. Third one, dealing with a floating point and complex literals. Okay children, these all are basics of this Python programming language. So study thoroughly, watch the videos carefully and write down the lecture notes. The notes of the topic is attached. Take down the notes and learn it. A test paper is also included. Submit your answers as soon as possible. That's all for today. We will meet in the next class. Till then, take care.